We've officially entered a new era of work, and video conference calls are a major part of our workday every day. Considering we've been using video calls more and more, even before the coronavirus pandemic, this isn't likely to change. That's why it's more important than ever to appear professional and look good on your video calls. Yes, you don't have accountability to dress professionally. And yes, people only see you from the waist up. And it's true, pajamas and sweatpants are the most comfortable thing to wear. But there have been multiple research studies conducted showing that what you wear can actually influence your thinking and negotiating skills, the way you think and feel about yourself, and the way people think and feel about you and your competence. Sure, you might not be going into the office, but people can still see you on video calls. And the truth is, your appearance does still matter for your own self and your professional image. Keep watching, and I will tell you exactly what to wear to look good on your video calls. If you're new here, hello! I'm so happy you found me, and be sure to leave a comment and say hi. If you've been following my videos, so glad you're back. New or old, if you are here for all things style and confidence, be sure to hit the subscribe button and catch all of my new videos. I'm Julie Morell, certified image consultant and creator of my private online coaching program, Professional Style Essentials, which you can find more information about below. I work with professional women in STEM to build their confidence through style so they can feel confident in their skin, get noticed for the incredible value they have to contribute, and move forward in their careers. I know that keeping your professional image in check, especially when you're working from home, is a new challenge for all of us. But I am here for it, and I am here to help you navigate this new normal. When it comes to choosing what to wear so you look good on video calls, there's one important concept to keep in mind: the portrait area. The portrait area is the area that is visible to your audience when you are on video. This can vary depending on how far or how closely you're sitting to the camera, but typically it's your upper torso to above your head. Simply put, it's the area surrounding your face. This is the area that people can see, so what you're wearing on your upper torso and above is what matters most. With that said, the first thing you need to wear to look good on camera is the right color for your skin tone. As an image consultant, I've been trained by two of the leading image consultants in the industry in color analysis. I've been trained to analyze my client's skin tone and teach them which colors will be most flattering for the pure pigments in their natural coloring. I show them the difference between which colors will make them look healthier, more alive and alert, and which colors will make them look dull, tired, or even sick.
You might be wondering, why should I care? But believe it or not, color can actually make the difference of having someone keep their attention on you and what you're saying, which is what really matters, versus having their attention drift away to another planet. This is especially important when you're on video and you're competing with all the other distractions in your colleague's environment. Without going into the technicalities of color, the rule of thumb is to wear color that gives you color. For example, for my skin tone, when I wear colors like mustard yellow, brown, or orange, they make me look sick.
These colors give me discoloration around my eyes and my mouth. They create the look of an uneven skin tone, and they emphasize shadows on my face. It's just not that appealing. Alternatively, blue, turquoise, pink, purple, those colors all give me healthy looking color and make me look more alert and present. I can tell you from experience that everyone has their own unique and beautiful natural coloring. And my clients say it makes the world of a difference when they finally understand their natural coloring and what colors look best on them. If you struggle with color and you want me to do a video to know how to know your best colors, leave a comment and let me know. The next important thing to keep in mind when you're deciding what to wear on video is to wear an appropriate and flattering neckline. What you don't want is to wear a top with a neckline that shows cleavage because it's inappropriate and distracting. So how do you know what kind of neckline to wear? The answer is in knowing your balance points. These are the points on your upper torso where you want your necklines and your necklaces to come to. We all have two balance points. To measure the first balance point, take your face measurement from your hairline to the bottom of your chin. Measure that distance from your chin to your upper torso, and this will be your first balance point. This is the lowest neckline you should wear on video or for work in general. To measure your second balance point, measure from the widest part of your face down to your chin. Then measure this distance from the place where your neck meets your shoulder and down. This is your second balance point and the height for your higher necklines. If you have a short torso, the second balance point may be the only appropriate balance point, so use your discretion. This rule can be used to know how low a neckline should go, but of course there are higher necklines like jewel necklines and boat necklines, mock necklines, and turtle necklines. These necklines are easy to wear without worrying if it's appropriate, but it brings me to my next point. To wear necklines that are flattering for you. The truth is, a turtleneck doesn't look good on everyone, just like a square neckline doesn't look good on everyone either. So how do you know which necklines are flattering for you? The answer is, you need to take into consideration the shape of your jawline and the length of your neck. When talking about necklines, typically you want to mimic the shape of your neckline to emphasize it. For example, my jawline angles in and down, so V-necks look great because they emphasize the shape of my jawline. In a similar way, a turtleneck will emphasize the length of your neck. So if you have a long neck, a turtleneck will make it look long, whereas if you have a short neck, a turtleneck will make it look shorter. If you have a short neck and you want to create the appearance of a longer neck, wear open necklines to create this effect. If you have a really long neck and you want to create the appearance of a shorter neck, wear higher necklines like boat necklines or jewel necklines. Ultimately, there is no right or wrong. If you like the length of your neck or the shape of your jawline, emphasize it. And now you know how. See if you can figure this out for yourself. Leave a comment and let me know what kind of neckline you think you should be wearing. Once you know what color and what neckline to wear, all you need to do is add some flavor to your appearance with some accessories. So which accessories will be visible in the portrait area? That'll be earrings, necklaces, it might be scarves, and it might be hair accessories. I prefer to just style my hair and maybe use bobby pins or elastics. So I'm not going to focus a lot on the hair accessories here, and we'll talk more about earrings and necklaces. The jewelry you choose will depend on the necklines you are wearing. The key is that you use accessories to add a little something to a space that would otherwise be plain. Keep in mind that you don't want your accessories to interfere with your neckline, and you want it to balance all out. With necklaces, we're going to go back to the concept of the balance point. For example, if your neckline is at balance point number one, like the top I'm wearing now, then your necklace should be at balance point number two, like what I'm doing here. If you're wearing a higher neckline, like a jewel neckline, a mock neckline, a turtle neckline, or a boat neckline, your necklace can come to balance point number one or balance point number two. When choosing earrings, you want them to balance out with the necklace. What that means is if you're wearing a larger necklace, you want to balance it out with smaller earrings like studs. If you're wearing a dainty necklace, you could wear larger earrings like hoops or dangly ones. And there you have it. Knowing what to wear so you look good on video calls really comes down to what you're wearing and what is visible in the portrait area. It's as simple as knowing what colors look best on you, 2, knowing what necklines are appropriate and flattering, and 3, wearing accessories that add flavor to your outfit. But if you have a wardrobe that is overflowing with clothes and you don't know what to get rid of and what to keep, be sure to download my checklist of the 17 essential items for a core professional wardrobe. If you learned something useful in this video, please give it a like. And if you know someone else that struggles with knowing what to wear on video calls, be a sister and send it to her. And if you haven't already subscribed, girl, hit the subscribe button because there is a lot more where that came from. See you next time.
If you're here. And I know that keeping your professional... These...